Hey guys, in today's video, I want to talk to you about the impact that an affair has on the betrayed spouse. See, typically, one of the challenges that the unfaithful partner struggles with is that there's a tendency to minimize or even justify one's behavior. And a lot of times it's done in the choice of language that is used. So when someone says, well, it was just only, or it was no big deal, or he or she didn't mean anything to me, or it was simply a mistake, or I was just acting dumb or stupid, that choice language really minimizes what was done. Oftentimes, an affair doesn't just happen like you slip on a banana peel and wind up in someone's bed. There are multiple decisions that are made along the way, calculated decisions, which speaks to the slippery slope that a person goes through morally that gets them to a place where they're actually willing to have an affair. So whether we're talking about a one-night stand or an emotional connection that goes too far or a long-term, full-on sexual affair, all of these behaviors tremendously impact the betrayed partner who didn't see it coming. You know, one of the men who's a part of the support group that we as Couples Academy have for those that have gone through our program said, when you have an affair on your spouse, think about Hiroshima and Nagasaki. These people were enjoying their day, minding their business. Some were eating in a cafe. Some parents had their children in a park swinging on a swing. Others were at work. Others were just resting. And then out of nowhere, bombs begin to fall out of the sky and literally transform their lives forever. It has been said that those who suffered the least are the ones who died instantly. But those who had the most pain are the ones who survived the explosion. Now, could you imagine days, weeks, months, and even years later, the post-traumatic stress disorder associated with that moment of trauma? Well, likewise, in an affair, it is a different form of trauma. And so as a result, people suffer from post-infidelity stress disorder. And so I want to talk to you quickly about the impact that it has on the betrayed spouse. So if you are the unfaithful spouse, you will operate with empathy, with sympathy, and with genuine remorse. Number one, it impacts the betrayed partner personally. Now, there are four aspects of who we are. We have our physical self, our spiritual self, our intellectual self, and our emotional self. And when you think about D-Day and when someone finds out, they're in the discovery phase. And that discovery phase can last for days, for weeks, for months. And if they haven't gone through a process of total restoration, discovery can last for years. And when a person is trapped in the pit of their own pain, it has a tremendous impact on them personally. So number one, physically, we know that there are many people who struggle with eating. They just can't eat, they can't hold anything down, and they're constantly vomiting. Or maybe they eat excessively, and now they're gaining all types of weight, right, because of the stress. Because oftentimes when people eat, they eat emotionally. Because they can't process and manage their emotions, they go to food because food is comforting and it appeases them for the moment, but it has long-term impact on their actual physical health. There are many people who struggle with sleeping. Literally, they cannot sleep. And so they're up into the wee hours of the morning and their mind is restless and they're constantly thinking about the affair. And because they don't have all the pieces to the puzzle to make sense of this, it causes their imaginations to run wild. Meanwhile, there are others who slip into a depression and all they do is sleep. They're always in the bed. The lights are always off. The shades are always down. They don't want to be bothered. They're in that saddened state. And really, that speaks to them emotionally. The emotional turmoil that an individual goes through is tremendous. And so when we think about the emotional scale, there are all types of emotions on this scale. And one end of the emotional scale is what we will call depression. That is when you have no energy, no desire to do anything. You don't want to get out of the bed to eat. You don't want to get out of the bed to bathe, to brush your teeth. You are just in a sunken space, and that's the impact that the affair has on you. But to the other extreme, on the opposite end of this emotional scale, is anger and rage. Now, understand that emotions are nothing more than energy in motion. And so Depression is a lack of energy, but rage and anger is an infusion of energy. And oftentimes that energy has to be utilized. And when you're in rage, oftentimes you're making decisions that are not helpful, that are not productive. And this is why we find so many betrayed spouses turning to violence, verbally abusing their spouse, because they're trying to get their partner to experience the pain that they are internally going through. And so emotionally, it could just cause someone to wind up in a tailspin. And so one moment they're crying, then one moment they're fine, and then the next moment they're enraged. And so this emotional volatility, or this emotional roller coaster, really keeps a person from having the level of stability that they need to function properly. And so they're constantly triggered everywhere they go and all throughout the day. And these type of triggers have to be managed, but these are the impacts that an affair can have on a person. It also impacts them intellectually, because in your mind, you begin to think thoughts, you begin to imagine, you begin to make sense of things based upon limited information that could be far off or spot on. But the point is, until you know everything, your mind begins to consume you. And either you're trapped in your past, which represents your pain, or you're anticipating a negative future outcome. So you're constantly back and forth from your past to your future, your past to your future, and don't get an opportunity to embrace your present moment. So intellectually, the affair gets the best of you. And then spiritually, it has an impact. For those who have faith, oftentimes they begin to question their relationship with God. And I thought I had perception, and I thought I had discernment, and I thought that God would reveal this to me. Why would He allow this to happen to me? So now there's a shifting of blame that takes place. We blame God, we blame the devil, we blame ourselves, we blame our partners, we blame the affair partner. Everyone gets the blame, and it impacts us spiritually. People stop going to church, they stop praying, or they begin to pray even more. It draws them closer to God. So what impact it has on one, it'll have a different impact on another. The second way that it impacts a betrayed partner is professionally. Now, I work with all types of people who are either business owners or corporate executives. A lot of them are doctors or lawyers or work for large major corporations, but the impact that it has on them professionally is really tremendous. When there's a lack of desire to even work, when you cannot focus on your job, and what you do is you push all the work away and you stay in your own mind, in your own emotions, which makes you highly unproductive. And so sales suffer, deals don't get done. If you are someone who serves other people, they're impacted because you're just not in a place that you need to be to function correctly. And it has a tremendous impact on your finances. I know people who couldn't even pay bills. I know people who deals dropped. They were out for several weeks, and so they're not getting paid. So the impact that it has on you financially, which is the next thing, number three, is tremendous. Number four, there's an impact on the betrayed spouse in terms of their family dynamic. Think about it. When you have had an affair on your partner, it's almost like having an affair on the entire family. Once the family finds out, particularly the children go through their own type of pain. And not only are they hurting, but now the betrayed spouse is hurting because of the hurt that they see their children going through. And oftentimes there's a struggle. Do I protect my partner by not letting anyone know? Do I keep the secret? Or do I find some type of comfort and some type of support and reveal the secret? So now there's a struggle with that internally. And if they reveal that secret to family members, whether it be siblings, or whether it be parents or close associates, now they're impacted because they have a pain that they see that their betrayed partner person is going through, and they want to accommodate that. And so when they begin to reveal this type of information, it hurts them as well. And so now they're forced to take sides and to be there for that individual. And oftentimes, as time passes, if there is a recovery process, understand the betrayed spouse, the unfaithful spouse, go through the recovery, but the family members do not. And oftentimes they can hold on to a pain for a long amount of time. They can hold on to the bitterness, the frustration, the rage, the animosity, the dislike, the vitriol towards the betrayed towards the unfaithful partner for what has been done. And so once that information is revealed to family members, it can have a tremendous impact on the family members, because if they were siblings or parents or cousins or really close associates, these individuals were in relationship with the unfaithful partner as well. And so now they're carrying a hurt, they're carrying a pain, and now they're empathizing with the betrayed spouse, which can cause a wedge with the unfaithful partner. And number five, there's a social impact that it has on the betrayed partner, because oftentimes when you're in a relationship and you've been married for a long period of time, there are friends, there's a community that you belong to, other couples that you congregate with. And when a couple is going through crisis, it puts everything to a halt. And now a person doesn't have a desire to go to church. They don't have a desire to congregate with their friends. They don't have a desire to double date. They don't have a desire to go out in public places because of the assumption, either I'm living a lie and I'm faking it for other people, or there's an assumption that other people may know and I don't want to be caught up in that level of shame. And so a person's world is impacted. And so it's critically important for the unfaithful partner to understand the emotional, spiritual, physical, financial, occupational, social, and family impact that it has on their spouse, and to have a level of sensitivity to it. And so in order to really help your partner heal, I would highly recommend you yourself go through a process of personal growth and self-development by getting help for you, getting help for your spouse, and getting help for your marriage. And this is why counseling is important. This is why a marriage intensive is important, because it is very difficult to overcome the trauma and pain in an affair on your own. It's going to take someone outside of you with a level of expertise and understanding that can guide you through that process. So call Couples Academy, set up a free discovery call, get the help that you need.